Hello everyone. So in this video, I'll be showing you how to create a Python program that gets the student details such as student's name, roll number and marks with the help of classes. So I'll be showing you two versions. One is by using individual objects and another one is by using multiple objects by using a for loop. Okay. So first, let's create a class. Okay, so it's going to be class and let the name of our class be equal to student. Okay, student. So the first thing what we need is we need a constructor to initialize all those values. So it's going to be def underscore underscore init again underscore underscore and it's going to be self. Okay, and next thing are the parameters that we're going to pass like the details, the roll name, roll number and the marks. So for name I will put n and for roll number I will put r and for marks I will put m. Just shortcut, you can even name like name, roll number, marks fully, but that's up to you. So here it's going to be self dot name equal to n and self dot marks equal to m or equal to m. Okay, so it's m and we have a roll number. Self dot r number equal to r. So this n value gets assigned to name, r to r number and m to mark. So this is how it works. Constructor used to initialize values. So once you're done with the constructors, we need a function or a method to display all those values of a particular object. So for that we are going to like declare a function. So it's going to be def. Let me just put display because it's just going to display our details. So display, it will take self as an argument, like default one. We'll be just doing print. Okay, so print, let's have like this name and a space. So put this space like between, so there'll be some gap between this name word and your student's name. So here it's going to be self dot name. So this is name, self dot name, and not this one, this n. You need to put self dot name. Let's close it and another print. It's going to be roll number, comma self dot r number. And next is print marks self dot marks. That's it. So now we are done with our class. We are done with our constructor and function. Now we are just going to create objects. So first I will be showing you how to create just basic individual objects. Okay, so first let me be st won't be my first student object. So our student class name is student and let me just put first argument is n. Okay, this is the default argument. First argument we have passed is name, so it should be of type string. So any name we are going to pass should be within double quotes so that it is like referenced as a string. So it should, so let me put the name John. Okay, so it is going to be the first name and next is roll number. I'll put 1 and I'll put a comma and mark I will be putting it as 90. That's fine. So just save this one. I will check whether it's working or not. So we can just call st1, that is our object name, dot display. That's it. So this is our object that you have created. So these are going to be the details. Name will be passed to n, r1 is for r, that is roll number, 90 is for marks. So this is our object st. This all the things will be like referenced by using this object. And if you call st1.display, okay, st1.display, and all these particular details will be printed in this format because we are calling this function. So only we can access a function with the help of our object. That is okay. In classes, this is the like the rule. You can only access a function or a method of a class by using the object. So st1 is our object. So using this object st1, we are accessing this function. So let me just save it and these values over here will be like transferred to this and self.name. So this name will be printed in this place, this line will be printed and roll number to 1 and 90 to this one. So it's actually mark. Okay, so really be careful, don't make a mistake like this. So it's mark. So let me just save it now and I hope like everything is fine. So let me just run it. That's really good, it works now. So let me just create another, okay, another object. So just paste it and let me create a student 2 and same thing, this is going to be student and let me just put Ravi something the name. We put 2 and I'll keep the marks as same. So this is going to be st2.display. Save it and now you can run it. So we'll be getting like two objects and probably two name that's get assigned over there. So now, but the problem with this method that like this individual objects method is that you need to like keep on doing this repeatedly. Let's suppose say that you want to find the mark and roll number for 10 students, you need to create 10 objects by this and you have to call 10 objects like this. So why to like do a particular thing repeatedly? And instead of that, we can use for loop. Okay, to like minimize our work. So we will be doing the same thing, but okay, so I'm just doing this all this stuff, and I'm going to use a for loop. Okay, so it's going to be, and before for loop, we need to like have the name, roll number, and marks of all the students in a list. Okay, so first let me do that. So let me put n. So n a m be my list. Okay, I'll put our n l. N l is fine. Name list equal to. So I will be putting just a b c for this purpose. You here you can just add any name. So I will be putting a b and c and d. Okay, that's fine. And next is the roll number list. So I'll put r l. Let me put 1, 2, 3, 4. Another important thing is that this should be within double quotes, okay? Because it's of type string. This is integer, so don't have no double quotes. And next is mark. So ml I will be putting. So let me put mark as some. We have all 100, 90, and 100. So that's fine. So it should be equal, okay? Because we are having like three parameters, which is like common for all. So 4, 4, 4 over here. And next thing is, we need to have another list, okay? Another empty list to append all these objects, okay? So our object list, so objl is going to be object list, which is going to be empty at first, okay? That's good. And now we are going to use the for loop. So for I in range is going to be 0 till 4, okay? So 0 till 4 means that it's going to be 0, 1, 2, comma 3. It is going to be 4 minus 1, okay? And why I'm putting 4 over here? Because in my list, I'm initialized 4, okay? Only 4 values are there, 4 items are there. So if you're having like 10, you can just go here and put 10. That's absolutely your choice. So next thing what we do is, we are going to create an object and we are going to just push that object into our object list. Okay, so in case of like the previously I had told about the individual objects, okay? So it was like, we will be passing st1 equal to student, and inside this we would be passing the name. We had passed the name John, and it was like mark, roll number, and mark as 90. So this was like the default syntax that we had earlier. So I'm going to do the same thing over here. Let's just copy this exact code. We'll copy it, and if I just paste it, so what I'm going to do is, so student is there, okay? We are having student, this is same, and this is a name, okay? So for name, what we are doing is, we will make use of this name list. So instead of John or name, we are just deleting this, and we'll be putting NL of I, okay? And same thing over here as well. So instead of roll number, we will be putting this roll number list. So it's going to be RL of I. And same for marks as well, ML of I. That's it. This is our way of creating an object. So what will happen is that when the loop runs, all these values will be going over here. So first, during the first iteration, A, 1 and 90 will go through this. And second iteration, that is when I becomes 1. B, 2 and 100 will go through it. And doing the I becomes 2, C, 3, 9, 90 will go through this, because 0 corresponds to A, this first item is 0, 1, 2, 3. So that's how list works. So that's it, we are well and good. And but another important thing is that we need to store this somewhere, okay? We can't just be creating it and like, we won't be having a reference, because here we like had st1 equal to student. So this reference gets stored in this object. So st1 becomes an object, but here we aren't having any object or reference. So in order to like solve that problem, we will be pushing this inside our object list. So let's cut this one. And now you come here. So just put objl dot append. Okay. Append is just pushing it inside a list. So append. So just paste this one. That's it. This is the code. So what happens is that when the for loop, this for loop will be running for 4 times. That is from 0, 1, 2, 3. So this 4 times, this 4 objects will be pushed into this object list. Okay, so now just save this, and now what I will do is, I'll just go in print objl. That's it. So just save it and just run now. So I'll be just getting this. So this will be showing, it says that main object student. Okay, it says that it has object. This is a type. Okay, this is not the value present inside it. It is a type and the address. So this is the address, I guess, in hexadecimal or something. So it says that there is an object stored in it, okay? So and it has like 1, 2, 3, and 4 objects stored in it. That what it refers to. And these 4 objects are nothing but all these things. A190 is one object. B20, 100 is values present inside one object. C390 is one values present in one object. And D400 are values present inside one object. That is what it shows in the output. And now how we can get the details, okay? Because basically we want to display the details. So what we can do is really simple, because in list, as I told you, right, it's like we can access a particular element or a value with the help of indexes in the list. For example, if I print NL of 0, it corresponds to A, RL of 1 corresponds to 2, ML of 2 corresponds to 90, plus 0, 1, 2. And same thing we can do here. What we are going to do is OBJL of 0. That's it. So this corresponds to the first object or first item present inside OBJ list. And we will be just putting dot display. We are just calling the function with the help of an object. So this corresponds to an object. This doesn't correspond to a list. It corresponds to the first item present in the list, which is an object, which corresponds to these values, 1A190. Same thing, like in the previous way, we had used this one, right? ST1.display. This is the previous one we used. Similar thing, this is an object, and we're just calling the display. So now if I just run it, I'll be getting A190. So I'm getting A190. These are this one, A190. And if I just do something, 2, okay? 2 corresponds to 0, 1, 2, which is C390. So just save it now. So I'm getting C390. So that's it. Really simple. I have shown you two ways. So I hope you would have found this video useful. Mine is a program channel. I run many other videos in Python, C, C++, Java, as well as SQL, as well as 3D animation in Blender. So do check out the videos of my channel. Subscribe and support me. Thanks for watching.